say that, do they? What's called a big job. And so what we are doing is we're asking the people who are the subject of Wikipedia articles to make a similar recording, which takes about 10 seconds, so that we can put that on their Wikipedia article. They came about in a pub, which is where the best Wikipedia ideas always happen, not far from here, when I was sat with Andrew Gray, who was the Wikipedian in residence at the British Library at the time, and we were talking about putting sound onto Wikipedia articles, things like car engines and canal locks leaking water or whatever other sound we might have of ambient things. And I said, oh, we ought to put people's voices on as well. And then I went home and wrote this blog post. And if you want to read it, there's a short URL for it. and I started by asking a few friends of mine, people I knew. One of the very first was Jack Schofield, who used to write the technology column for The Guardian. And then we'd stick the recording onto the Wikipedia article. There are two reasons for doing this. One is so that we know what the person sounds like. We have the impression of their personality from their voice. And if you ever listen to very old recordings, there are some around of Florence Nightingale and Alexander Graham Bell, it gives you a little bit of an idea about the person. But the other thing is, how do they pronounce their surname or their whole name? So Schofield is quite an unusual name, and certainly for a non-English speaker, it can be very difficult to know, you know, Schofield, Schofield. God knows, I've had my surname mispronounced enough times. So we have the canonical version of how that name is pronounced. Nobody can argue that Jack's pronunciation of his name is not the right one, whereas if a Wikipedian reads that name, they might be mispronouncing it. But that's why we started. And as I say, we just used to stick them on articles, and that looks really ugly. So we now embed them in info boxes like that. So if you want to add one to an article, that's how to do it. And there's the underlying code, which you don't need to worry about unless you're the sort of person who does this coding. But we use, on the English Wikipedia, a template called Listen. And other Wikipedias have similar templates. And of course, Wikidata will give you the interwiki link to tell you where those templates belong. And we ask people to make these recordings. Oh, sorry, I'm getting ahead of myself. We then categorise the recordings on Wikimedia Commons, and there's the list of categories for this one. So we categorise by the project, which is the voice intro project, and then the language, in this case -en for English. And there are some generic categories for audio files as to what format they are and what the subject is and so on. And we add them to Wikidata. So these files are now available for people to machine query. So somebody can say, I'm interested in this person, send a request to Wikidata, is there a sound file of what this person sounds like, and receive it programmatically for embedding in their own website or whatever else. And if you use a tool called Reasonator, which is a front end for Wikidata, you'll see how that sort of thing works. But Reasonator will do that query and put you a player for the audio, even if there isn't a Wikipedia article about the person, in the language of the person using Reasonator. The Wikidata property is P990, again for those of you who are geeky enough to care about that sort of thing. But I can't do all this on my own. I ask people I know to make these recordings, and I quite often use social media, particularly Twitter, to say to famous people or notable people, they don't necessarily have to be celebrities, they could be academics or scientists or whatever, please would you provide us with one of these recordings? But I need more people to do that. I need you to sort of think about the people you know who might have a Wikipedia article about you. People you know personally in your family or in your professional life, or people you're writing about if you're contacting them to verify some information you might ask them this at the same time. So we have this project page on Commons. And again, there's the Commons address of that page, the shortcut if you want to go to it. So that you can find out what to do and what to say. And you can point people at that if they're interested in making a recording of their own voice. And we included the script. You see the little indented paragraph at the top is basically what I just said to you at the beginning of this talk. And people can adapt that for themselves. As I say, that takes about 10 seconds to say. We don't mind if people talk for longer, but less than 10 seconds really, and it's not particularly worth having. So that's a nice little short piece of text. Fairly standard. People have variations on that. That's not a problem. Some people like to include their birth date, and others obviously don't. But they can do what they want with that. And what we ask people not to do is not to say, hello Wikipedia, or anything that mentions Wikipedia or Commons or Wikidata, because this audio could be used somewhere else. So it's not, in the same way as in an article we don't talk about the fact that the article's on Wikipedia, unless it's about Wikipedia, then we don't want that in the audio. And we ask people not to pitch for work, not to use advocacy, whether it's religious, political or whatever, and generally to keep things neutral in line with Wikipedia's policy on neutrality. And we've only had one problem with that. Unfortunately, the person said, I'm freelance and available for hire, right at the end of the recording, so I was able to just edit it off and upload the rest of it. And that help page is available in these languages. So I should have asked you before I told you this, but you can guess what's coming next. How many of you speak a language other than English? Right. If your language is one of those, put your hand down, please. So we've still got a couple of hands up. Good. Your homework is to go home and translate this project page into your language on Commons so that people who speak your language know what to do if they want to contribute to this project. Thank you very much for volunteering. So how's it going? Well, we've got these 83 files in English. You can see there's a category on Commons specifically for English, as I mentioned earlier. Some of you are doing better than others in your own languages. So we have one Welsh file. Thank you, Robin. We've got Robin employed in Welsh and in English. We have 215 in Russian. I have no idea why the Russians have taken to this so well. I'm very grateful that they have. Okay, don't worry. But there are a lot there where there's only one or two, and there are a lot where there are no files at all. So, you know, where is Dutch? Where is, let me see what else we've got on there. Where is, we've got Hungarian, where's Polish? We've got a few, okay, I'm picking bad examples. But you can see, you know, we've got 280 languages on Wikipedia, and there are 13 where we have files at the moment. That's not enough, so we need more. I just want to mention this one as a little aside, because I'm particularly proud of this one. Can anybody tell me why that voice file is particularly important? The person who recorded it is in a very exclusive category. People who have walked on the moon. So we've got some of my mates have done this, but we've also got some very famous and influential people who've done it, which is really nice. We have a couple of problems. The first one is if you try to upload an MP3, this is what you see. Commons doesn't accept MP3 files or any of the other popular formats. It only accepts ARC or FLAC files, the open standards. And it's difficult for people to know how to convert them. There is an online conversion tool, but it's geeky and difficult to use. And we're asking busy people who have Wikipedia articles about them, who aren't Wikipedians, who don't want to get involved, and they say, well, yeah, if I'm going to do it quickly, I'll do it, but if I'm going to have to learn about file formats and all the rest of it, that wouldn't work very well, then I'm not interested. So we have to make it easy. And I have people at the moment from the hackathon over the last couple of days who are very kindly working on a website. This isn't it, this is an independent one that we sometimes use, but they're working on a website that will be like this, where you'll have a button to click to record. You will type in the Wikipedia article title of the article about you, you'll type in your email address, you'll click a button that says I agree to an open license. The file will be uploaded, the email will be sent to OTRS, copied to the individual for them to confirm, so we can check if they really were the person who gave the permission. And a human volunteer will then get a notification once they reply to that to say it needs to be updated. Do you have a question?
What's the ideal file format for uploading WAV files to Commons?
They have to be OGG or OGG, FLAC. Yeah. FLAC is the lossless format. But OGG is easier for some people to do. AudioBoo is another tool you can use to do an online recording. But something very interesting happened not long after this project had started, which is a guy from the BBC, who is a friend of mine, left this comment on my blog, don't worry about reading it, but it's quite a long comment saying, let's collaborate. And unfortunately, Michael couldn't be with us today, so Zilla Watson has very kindly come down from the BBC to tell us how this project progressed.
I'm Zilla Watson. I used to be a radio producer, but now I'm at BBC's Research and Development Engineering Arm. They're the people who invented colour TV. One of the projects we've been looking at recently is called the World Service Archive Prototype. And what
next thing that happened after this wonderful collaboration with BBC, and by the way, we called the event Speakathon. So if you search for Speakathon online, you can find blog posts about it and so on. The next thing that happened was this guy, do you all know who he is? Stephen Fry, well-known British television celebrity, actor, raconteur, tech geek, agreed to record his voice for us. And I approached his PA through his website and said, would Stephen do this? And they said, yes, what do you want him to say? A couple of weeks later, the sound file arrived, I uploaded it, added it to his article. I got back to the PA and said, would Stephen tweet about this, please? And they said, yes. Tell us what you want him to tweet. So I wrote the tweet. So my CV now says scriptwriter to Stephen Fry. But he tweeted at 11 o'clock on a Saturday evening. I just got back from an event in London, another Wikipedia event, when I noticed this tweet at about half past 11 at night or so. And things went ballistic. It was over 6 weeks later before people stopped retweeting or commenting on his tweet. Every single day for over 6 weeks. I literally lost count of all the tweets. And the press picked up on it. And at the same time, this was about the time we were doing the Speakathon, and they badly conflated the story. And this also happened about a year after we initially launched the project. And we had a wonderful press story saying, Stephen Fry launches Wikipedia project. Stephen Fry launches BBC voice project. So, you know, don't believe everything you read in the papers. But it did give us some wonderful publicity. There's the voice file of Stephen Fry article. So we had, you know, the British press covering it. We had the tech press and the gadget and so on covering it. We had the Arabic press coverage, press covering it. Other than those four words there, I've no idea what that says. It might be rubbishing you completely. And we had languages that I don't even recognise covering it. So it went all around the world. And we collated on Commons a list of all the press articles. We got up to 16 different languages, and then we stopped because there were just too many. So it's a very incomplete list of comments, but there are well over 100 press articles from around the world about that. Now, you'd think that was marvellous. We got fantastic publicity. How many extra voice recordings did we get by, not as part of the BBC project, but directly being sent in by people as a result of all that publicity? How many do you think?
10.
Yeah, about 10 or a dozen. It really didn't take off like we hoped it would. And we have this problem, I talked earlier about the need to provide a better web interface for it. But overall on that project I showed you earlier, we have 80 odd English language voice articles, voice clips rather, in articles. And this project has been running for 18 months. So I'm very concerned that although we've got a project which everybody we tell about it goes, oh, that's brilliant, why didn't I think of that? We should do that. Well, we have all this wonderful press coverage as a result of somebody famous contributing to it. We have some very interesting sound clips already. As I said earlier, it's a very short thing to ask somebody to do. And yet we don't have a great take-up. And I don't know the answer to that. So my appeal to you today is come and tell me what we could do differently to make it better. But also, how can you help? Sorry, let me pass that one. So, your homework, if you're not going to be one of the people who translates that help page for me, for the rest of you, is to go away and record somebody's voice. You know somebody who is on Wikipedia, who has an article about them, in English or in your own language, or both, then go and record them. Walk up to them with a mobile phone and say, can you say these 10 or 20 words that are written on this bit of paper, fill in the blanks with your own name, let them record it on Commons, and then add it to the Wikipedia article. It's that simple. Or maybe on your wiki project, start running a campaign to get other people. Hi.
How does it work with copyright?
You make the recording, it's your copyright. Because we've written a script, there's no intellectual property in what's being said. It's not like getting somebody to recite a play that they've written or something. So as long as you make the recording. If the person makes the recording themselves and emails it in, then we need to either get them to upload it to Commons, or if they email it in, we can go through OTRS and get the permission. That's how most of them are done. But there's my challenge to you, your homework today, is to either go away and make a recording, or to evangelise about this and talk to people in your language, Wikipedia, or your other Wiki project about it. So I think I'm pretty much done. That's my contact details if you want to talk to me. My Twitter name is also my Wikipedia username. Hi.
Yeah, I wanted to comment on the
clip from another source, if you have permission, which we have with the BBC, they wrote to OTRS and gave us permission for all the 500 odd clips that we've used, or if it's an open licensed document already. So if it's a presentation from Wikimania, then you can take the audio off it, because they will have an open license, like Creative Commons licenses or whatever. But what you need to watch then is that you're picking out the appropriate words, that you have a nice short clip that actually makes sense. Because just having a clip of somebody talking about something else might not be so useful. And you also need to watch things like background noise and background music. One of the things you have to watch is you can't use anything where there's music playing in the background, because the music will be copyrighted even if the speech is. Okay, well, that's the end of the presentation. Zula and I are happy now to answer any questions you might have. At the back.
Ms. Saira Watson mentioned that there is an automated voice recognition facility. Automated transcription facility.
Yes.
So, for example, if somebody is speaking and there are similar sounding words, bear, air, there, etc.
Yes.
Is there an automatic correction application also in use?
I don't know about that. What we do with the clips that we put on the English Wikipedia and indeed some of the other languages is we add a transcription manually, so it appears as closed captions.
Did you mean
the
World Service Archive?
Thank you very much.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah. We're saying that there is an automated transcription.
Yes. See, what that does is it creates a crude transcription of it. It's not useful for humans, and then tries to relate some of those words to wiki tags. So that's what it does.
Wikipedia article titles.
Wikipedia article titles, and that's
copyright and so on. What about stuff where the copyright has lapsed? So, for example, a recording of Shakespeare, or when my dad used to do Book of Bedtime many years back, and quite a few of the books he used in that were ones that had sort of just come out of copyright. Have you considered releasing clips from that, and would there be any problem with that?
Well, I have to say, it took me quite a long time to persuade the powers that be in the BBC to take a risk on this stuff. That this was very much a first stage, and yes, of course, we could do that, but actually, I'm not sure whether we need to, because in so many, if we're trying to find actors and people like that, we've got so many programmes, Front Row and arts programmes on the World Service, where actors do interviews. We managed to find lots and lots of people through that, so it may not even be necessary to find them.
And there's already the LibriVox project for the recording of public domain books that publish their work under a public license, under a free license, I mean.
Liam, have you got a question? You have to shout.
My name's Liam White, Australian, formerly University of the British Museum, and a long-time fan of my own correspondent.
Okay, I think we're out of time, but Zilla and I will be around for a little while if anyone wants to. talk outside. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Right, okay, if you want to go. still not a lot of money for 25,000, but
it's a beginning.
Yeah, I think now that Army's team is connected to the Wikimedia world, we're really starting to actively change those policies and try to use it as open as possible.
Yeah, I think FBL basically raised a really important point here before giving the stage to Alison, who is from Brazil. And that is to go back a bit in terms of our So you kind of almost have the broad picture of what's happening in Glams and what happened in Sweden and Italy in terms of fashion. And I'll very quickly, because we don't have time and we do want to have some kind of discussion, I'll go through what happened in Israel. So as I said before, we didn't have much happening in terms of fashion coverage in Hebrew Wikipedia. And when Marco contacted me and said, well, would you like to have and